Hey everybody, it's Alex with Engineering Applied. In this video, I'll be giving you an overview of the mirror command found within an Autodesk Inventor assembly file. If you want more easy to understand and practical content like this, made by an experienced engineer like myself, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any helpful content like this in the future. If you're looking for a specific function, check the description for timestamps. And if you don't find what you're looking for in this video, I encourage you to check out the other videos in my Autodesk Inventor series playlist because I know you'll find exactly what you need there. Let's get started. Okay, everybody. So here we are in our first assembly file. And what we're doing here is we're taking a look at the end product for this mirror command. So what we're taking a look at in this particular case is a draft shield. Now, you might recognize this from a previous video on assembly constraints, and I'll just briefly explain what a draft shield is and what it's for. So essentially what you do is you put a high sensitivity scale on the inside of this enclosure, and this enclosure just protects the scale from any sort of air blowing in the environment that you're working in and dust and that kind of stuff. So this is perfect if you're outside of a clean room that has positive pressure on the inside of the room, therefore forcing air out of it, and you don't want air blowing onto your scale as you're trying to take reliable readings because it can screw up the reliability of your readings that you're getting on your scale. So anyhow, what we're going to be doing here is we're going to be replicating these corner brackets that are spread around the corners of this enclosure using the mirror command. So we'll be constraining just one of these brackets, and then we'll just replicate it on both sides of this enclosure, which saves us a ton of time while putting together our assembly file. Okay, so I went ahead and deleted all of those extra corner brackets and fasteners with the exception of this one corner bracket here in the bottom left-hand corner. The first step we need to pay attention to is we need to create some reference geometry in which to mirror these components over. We'll go up to the work feature section here in the ribbon, go to this dropdown, and we'll use the mid-plane between two planes option. I'll select this face and this face, and it drops a plane that's mid-plane between those two outer faces. And we're going to do the same thing in this direction now. So we'll open up this drop-down, mid-plane. We'll get this face and this face. And we'll do this one more time. We need to get a plane sort of in the middle of this framework here. So we'll go to mid-plane once again. I'll pick up this interface and this interface, and you'll see we have our three main reference planes that we'll be using to mirror these components over. Now that we have all of our reference geometry in place, let's go ahead and click on mirror in the pattern section of the ribbon, and you'll see we get our mirror components command window that pops up. Starting in the upper left-hand corner of this command window, we have our component selection filter. So this is what we use to pick up the various components that we want to replicate or mirror in this case. So you'll notice that there's a blue fill inside of this box. That means this selection filter is currently active. Moving to the right, we have our mirror plane selection filter. So this allows us to pick up various planes, faces, and so on and so forth, in which to mirror our selected components about. Okay, so when we click on this, we activate the filter, and we can pick up various reference planes like we'll be doing in this lesson, or you can pick up faces that are associated with your model geometry, or you can also use the various planes that are part of the origin that's associated with the assembly file, okay? So you'll see I have my origin folder open here under the assembly, and you'll notice that it pre-selects those as I click on these tiles. Now you can also use this selection filter and hover over these and select it this way as well. Now let's go ahead and select our component of interest, which is this angle bracket here in the corner. So again, we can either click on the component directly or we can pick it up in the model browser. If you click on something by mistake, so let's say for example, we accidentally clicked on this rail on the bottom, what you can do is you can hold the shift key, hover over the part that you want to remove, and then left click while holding shift, and you'll see that goes away. Okay, so it's no longer blue and it's no longer in this selection window. Now that we selected our component, let's go ahead and select the mirror plane that we want to use to mirror this component around. So let's go ahead and click on this tile here, and we'll first mirror it over this plane here. So what we'll do is we'll just hover over it until it turns green and left click, and you'll see that we get a preview of the mirrored component here in the bottom right hand corner. Now let's go ahead and continue on, but I want you to pay attention to the color of the preview here in the bottom right-hand corner, and I want you to pay attention to the symbology here next to each component name. Now, you might be wondering why we still cannot toggle the status on these components. Well, what we first need to do is we need to select a component of interest, and then these will populate. So we'll go ahead and click on angle bracket, and you can see now we have our three options available to us. Now, bear in mind, within this window, we can also see the hierarchy of the component that we selected and its relationship to the overall assembly. So you can see this angle bracket is linked to our top level assembly, which is called Mirror Command Example. Moving up to the status section, we have our first option, which allows us to mirror the selected components. So essentially what this does is not only does it mirror the original component around the plane of interest, but it creates a new file extension for this replicated part. Okay, this next option allows us to reuse the selected objects. So if you're not interested in creating a new part, but you want to add additional instances of your selected component, this is what you want to use. So I would be willing to wager about 99% of the time you'll be using this particular option, because if you're using standard parts like fasteners and multiple places in your assembly, you don't necessarily want to create new part files of the same fastener. You just want to use additional instances of it. Okay, and it'll keep everything in your bill of materials nice and tidy. Now, this final option allows us to exclude the selected object. So if I click on this, you'll notice that the symbol changes here next to these various designations within this hierarchy, and you'll notice that the preview has gone away. So if I were to click on reuse, you'll see that the preview color turns yellow. So this is just a helpful way for us to recognize exactly what's going on with these replicated components at a glance. Okay, so let's go ahead and move down and take a look at the next options. Here we have mirror relationships, which allows us to maintain the relationships or constraints that we have in the model. Now, as we progress through this lesson, I'll make some important distinctions in when various relationships are maintained and when they are lost. Okay, so I encourage you to pay very careful attention to that. So as you're working through your models, you know when you can use this and when you cannot use this. Okay, so moving down, we have ground new components. Simply put, any new components that are created are grounded or fixed in 3D space. Moving down to the bottom, you'll see that we have this extended menu with some additional options. To access this menu, all you have to do is click these arrows in the bottom right-hand corner, okay, and it'll drop down that extended portion of the menu. Now, this first option within the extended menu allows us to set the initial status of all standard library components to reuse by default. So when we're using standard hardware, for example, from the Autodesk Inventor content library, it sets the status for those components to reuse rather than mirroring them with this green symbol, okay? So again, the green symbol will create a new file extension and a new part based on the originally selected components, whereas reuse just uses additional instances of your originally selected part, which is what you'll want to use most of the time, unless you're purposefully trying to derive or create a new part file based on your originally selected component, okay? So moving on, we have our preview component section. So this allows us to toggle the preview for various components. So whether it's our mirrored components or reused components. So you see when we toggle this box, we get our preview over here, it disappears, okay? And then moving over to the right, we can toggle our standard content visibility. So that is the basic overview of everything within this command window. So let's go ahead and utilize this, and I'll walk you through these various options in practice. Okay, so let's go ahead and proceed with the example. So we'll go back up to mirror, we'll select our angle bracket, and let's select our mirror plane of interest, which is this one here. Okay, and now you notice we have this green preview of our new angle bracket here in the bottom right-hand corner. Okay, so we'll go ahead and start with this. So again, the green symbol is mirroring the selected object. Okay, so let's go ahead and click next and see what happens. We get this new pop-up window that shows us some information based on our new replicated component. Now, I want you to remember that whenever we use this green status or mirror the selected components, it creates a new part file of the originally selected component rather than just creating new instances of it, okay? So with that said, we can change the display name of the replicated part, we can change the file name, and then of course the location of this new file. So let's go ahead and change some of this information. So we'll go ahead and just enter some sample text, and I'll just type sample text here so you can see what that looks like. Okay. And then in the file name, let's pretend that we're creating a left-hand and a right-hand version of a product. Let's say that we started with the left-hand version of it, and we want to mirror this component to create a right-handed version of it. So let's go ahead and change this to RH for right hand, and let's change our source path. Okay. So I'll just go ahead and paste my path there. Okay. So I have my file extension pathway. Okay. So I want you to look up in this window and look at each individual field and see how these strings of text are implemented in each one of these relevant sections. This first column here shows us our source component display name. So this is the display name that's shown in the model browser. So you'll see angle bracket one, that's our originally selected component here. And here you see its name presented. Moving over to the right, we have our source file name, which is the actual file name for that source component. Okay, so it's called angle bracket. And moving over to the right, we have our display name. So this is the display name of the newly mirrored component. And as you can see here, we have the text from this particular space. So it's going to use the file name with the additional text after it. So you'll see it says angle bracket underscore RH for right hand. And then here it has sample text after the file name. Okay. So that's how these particular text fields come into play with the display name. And then moving over to the right, we have our file name, which just takes the information from this box here. So it takes the source file name, which is angle bracket, and then adds the underscore RH for right hand. Continuing on, we have our location column, and this shows us where our new file is going to be saved. Okay. And then finally, we have our status column, which shows us the status of these various components. Moving down, we also have the option to create a new assembly based on this replicated component. Okay. So let's go ahead and try that. So we'll check this option and we'll click OK. So you'll see it opens up a new assembly file with our new component in it. Okay. So this is useful if you want to go ahead and consolidate a couple steps all in one go. But in this case, we don't want to save this as a new assembly. So we'll exit out of this. We don't need to save that. And let's go ahead and go back into Mirror, and we'll use the reuse option. So we'll reselect all of our entities. We'll select our angle bracket, and then we'll use the reuse option. Okay. Now, like I mentioned previously, the reuse option is nice because it doesn't create a new part file. It just simply creates new instances of the original part file within the model, as if we placed multiple instances of components using the place command. Okay. So this is really convenient for us to use. Okay. So let's go ahead and drop this in 3D space. Let's leave the ground new components unchecked, so you can see what this looks like. Now we get the same pop-up window as the green status or the mirror the selected components option, but none of this will actually come into play because we're actually reusing the components and not creating new part files. So we'll go ahead and click OK. And now you see our new component is in our 3D space. Now I want you to note that when I click and drag this, it still moves around even though the original component is fully constrained. This is because when you replicate individual parts, it's not going to hold the original relationships between various components. Now, if I were to go in and replicate this entire assembly and just mirror it over a plane, then I can hold all of those constraints with reference to one another for the new entire assembly. And I'll show you that right now. Let's go ahead and go up to Mirror. And instead of selecting individual components this time, let's select the entire assembly. So I'll just click on the assembly name here. We pick up the entire assembly. Let's change the assembly to reuse. So I just selected the assembly name here in this window and switch it to reuse. Okay, so it's going to reuse all of these components rather than creating new part files for it. And then let's go ahead and select our mirror plane as this plane here. Okay, so I just created an extra plane out here in space so it's easier to see. Okay, we have our preview here for our reused assembly. And let's go ahead and leave this mirror relationships box checked. So this is going to maintain all of the relationships within the assembly. Okay, so whereas before we could still click and move that one part around because we're only replicating one part in the context of an entire assembly, this time when we copy the whole assembly or mirror the whole assembly, it's going to retain all of the constraints. So you can imagine if I wanted to create a left-hand and a right-hand version of this particular assembly, this is a great way to do it because I don't have to build a whole new assembly. I can just mirror this, keep all of the constraints together, and it's going to operate just like this side did, but it's flipped the door around. So this is really convenient for me. So let's go ahead and hit next. Okay, again, we don't need to worry about anything in here because we're reusing the components, so we're not getting any new files or anything like that. We'll click okay. And so now we have our new assembly. So it's even copied all of the reference geometry. So I want to show you here, I can't just click and drag anything. So I've got all of my constraints in place like I had in this assembly. So that is what that checkbox allows you to do. And that's why you were able to move the angle bracket over here, but you can't move in anything in this assembly because all of the constraints are being held and respected in this particular case. So let's go ahead and take a step back and we'll continue on with the lesson. So let's go ahead and undo that. We'll go back to mirror. Okay, so now let me show you grounding new components. So we'll just go ahead and select this real quick. We'll select that. Okay, so it flips it over to that side. Let's go ahead and just reuse this and we'll ground it. So this time we'll hit next and okay. But when I go to click and drag this, it doesn't move. And you see I have the little push pin symbol next to the ground symbol. And that basically means that this component is grounded or fixed in 3D space. So I can't move it anywhere. So if you know that you don't need to change your model and you're okay with grounding components so they don't move around, this is a fast and easy way to do that with the mirror command. Now let's go ahead and finish up this example. Now I know I've taken a lot of detours along this tutorial, but I've done that with purpose because I want to make sure that you're understanding what all of these little options do and how they actually work, because I know it can be frustrating sometimes to read a description of a particular function but not actually see what it does. So it's really important to me that I try to show you as much as I can so that you can fully understand what you're looking at. So with that said, let's go ahead and go back into mirror. Let's go ahead and select our two angled brackets here on the bottom. Okay. We'll select our mirror plane as this particular mirror plane here. And you'll see we have our two new components here at the top, but let's go ahead and make sure that these are reused so that we're not saving any new file names. Okay, so that looks good. We'll go ahead and hit next and okay. Now we have four corner brackets here. Let's go ahead and mirror all four of these onto the other side now. So we'll go back into mirror. We'll pick up all four of these. Okay, we'll select this as our plane of interest. And we'll set these to be reused. So we'll hit next and okay. We'll go ahead and rotate the model around. And as you can see, all of my corner brackets are exactly where I need them to be without spending all of the extra time and placing these components individually. Now, one final word of caution is I would say make sure that you're practicing good design intent in conjunction with the use of this command. So don't just overuse the mirror command in an effort to cut corners, okay? So this is not a corner cutting tool. This allows you to speed up your workflow and create new instances of certain components if the design allows you to do that. But if your design needs those constraints to be placed individually, so maybe your design is always changing its shape and its size and whatnot, maybe that's not a good time to use the mirror command. Okay, so make sure you're making intelligent decisions on when you should and should not be using the mirror command. That's all for this segment of the Autodesk Inventor Assembly Creation Module, where I gave you an overview of the mirror command. I really hope that you found this tutorial to be helpful and that you put what you've learned into practice so you can continue developing your skills as you work your way through these lessons. Also, before you watch the next video in the series, make sure you subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications to stay up to date on future content that will help you create the future you want for yourself. And of course, don't hesitate to leave a comment or reach out via my website contact page and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to learn about or see on this channel. I really appreciate you choosing to stop by and learn with me, and I'll see you again soon.